Broadcasting from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden, The Golden Cockerel, a fairy tale after Pushkin, in three acts by Rimsky-Korsakov.
I have lived my life, I am sick and tired of strife, and I long for peace and quiet. But my neighbors, just to spite me, seem intent on war and strife. For they seem to plague my life. Really, it is an awful bother when one country fights another. I must keep my forces straight, some have overworked of late. I was born on falling hatchet, they will drive us to destruction.
From the murders of the stranger, and if nothing intervenes, I have planned a subtle means.
If you stop to think and ponder, it is sure your mind will wander.
We have labors left and right, but you need to be polite. They have but to cross the border, and we fly in great disorder.
Yes, from there we make a stand. They will all
let that you be summoned hither, centralized and grouped together, while behind the ramparts will be laid a score of their strength in foolish passion, looting village, burning farms, being feet and perfect man. Crafty plan of action working, may contrive to catch them back in turn. Be so witty, can't such foolishness proclaim? I'm ashamed he bears our name.
proper course to pursue. Hear my advice. Let a horse full of herring pay for carries out in herring. Great return to a hut and a home, there to wait a month to come. Then in manner unexpected, by our generals well directed, sally forth to meet the foe, heel to heel and toe to toe. Victory won and crowned with glory, but they can't all tell the story.
And they can't all tell the story.
Be thy faithful guide. me feel afraid. Oh, thy land in tenue rain, or a sky through disappearing, or is blessing ever nearing, then to warm the countryside, he will call out far and wide, flap his wings and nod his head, warm the voice of nature's bread.
Okay. heart and always gaily sporting, out of merry courting, I shall believe in fact King Jordan was e'er a child. Hail, O radiant sun outpouring, healing vent to your restoring, shall your blessings to receive. Something leads me to believe that a nap would be in keeping. Understand a word. I am listening to you vainly. Can't you speak a bit more plainly? Pray interpret.
This is this. At the window he whips it to attract the passing faces by his little elven graces.
Silly Polly, you are proud and conceited.
Thank you.
I must await it, a calamity, what I think vanish off the ball, old king.
What's the cause of this commotion?
By the foe we are surrounded.
Hey, what's that? What's biting you? Is my palace all ablaze?
There's a pretty king, the cock's crowing. He's most unquiet in the town. There is a riot. Beside it, as well I will not stand. Come, my bed is upside down. Now my 40 weeks resuming, I shall rest, that is presuming no one wakes me up again. And a penalty of pain. Ah, the dream of white rapture. Seek a melva to recapture by some subtle means, for I cannot well recall.
Just wait, trust my powers of invention. Pleasing you is my intention. Now what was it? As I guess, you are king in game of chess. After seven moves or doubles, your opponent is in trouble. Queen and bishop, rook and knight, put to ignominious sight. Seek to hide their heads diminished long before the game is in.
And nature's fair, full of wonder so inspiring.
Here it is then. You are seated in your bath, lathered all with soapy froth, thinking of your sleep approaching, when a little sprite encroaching, hell by and death of me, would torment you with embrace. Oh, I know I'm on the wheel, causing many pins and needles to arise on me so bright.
Hey, the dream of beauty lies.
Some impression I can glean from your expression. Safe in secret rendezvous on a couch prepared for two. In my shade of milk and curtain lie the maiden, that is certain.
He left praying. out of Satan.
Oh, beloved people's father, oh, a king against me, all undone.
And why thy presence here?
In the town there is a riot, breaking all our peace and quiet. Once again there comes the foe, the least expect the foe. We are living in ignorance. It's an ugly situation. We must call up our preserves.
Wait a moment till I rise.
Not for nothing is he crowing. We must rally and be going. Young and old must make a stand to the rescue of our land. Bring my shield, my sword and sabre. Though to join will mean hard labor, I desire again to feel hat on head and spur on heel.
And rusted armor spoiling for the want of simple oiling.
This time belt, once letting out, I have grown a trifle stout. Yet my buckle, though 'tis larger, shall be seated on a charger.
Devil take you, noisy guest. Why disturb a king at rest? Is he quiet like a lamb? Then he's just a horse for me.
Why departing with no food? Dear one.
On the way I eat. Are we ready? More than ready. Then away I am deciding.
Thank you.
Look at that. A tent. Oh, a rider.
Is the foe conceived in it?
Rather should he now is taken.
Man the guns, be quick and load them. Set the fuses and stand by.
Fire. young woman greets us tenderly, 'tis plain that we might as well remain. Lovely maid, there is no danger. I would greet so fair a stranger. If he would like to know your name, tell us then from whence you came.
patience, patience. Give him time. Oh, you tug, you silly fellow, or I'll beat you till you mellow. With your silly roving eye, can't you see the girl is shy? Get behind the tent at once, out of sight, and watch your step.
that's not a flattering thing to say. I am not more, if you count in years.
A score!
Since I was three.
Thank you.
how to tame the wildest creature. See the time of wildest rule. Show a one and one make two. By the force of will you run it, I will stay a crazy one. In a word, I'll render thee just as closer as to me. All the steps
that these were made for dancing.
In my youth I was entrancing, but my costume's natural smart for the terpsichorean part.
And to my neighbor kings for dancing garbed the river.
And the proper garb I own, if you take me for a clown. This is odious, disgrace. Send your wrecking you away.
I defy them all to stay. Why deprive them of their play?
Thank you. I have money, live a life of milk and honey. Any troubles I possess, all are yours if you'll say yes. Share with me my bed of roses. Do you want his head cut off?
Thank you. and why?
Nay, I know not.
As am I. We are in a sort of danger. Yonder. Since the golden stranger.
Thank you.
You're in time to see my wedding. All I have is yours to ask for.
Thank you.
upon our wedding morning is a most untimely warning. Some mishap will fall on me.
We shall see what we shall see, that is all.
In lover's rapture, once again our love recapture.
Thank you.
That is the end of The Golden Cockerel, a fairy tale after Pushkin in three acts by Rimsky-Korsakov, broadcast from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. The cast was as follows. King Dodon, Howell Glynn. Prince Guidon, John Lanigan. Prince Afron, Geraint Evans. General Polkan, Frederick Dahlberg. The astrologer, Hugues Queneau. Amelfa, Barbara Howitt. The Queen of Shemaka, Matawilda Dobbs. And the Golden Cockerel, Arda Mandakian. With the Covent Garden Opera Chorus, Chorus Master Douglas Robinson, and the Covent Garden Orchestra leader Charles Taylor. The conductor was Igor Markovich, and the opera was produced by Robert Hilton. The introduction to each act was written by David Harris.